On Nationwide this evening, a Meath farm where the crop is flowers, and at this time of year, daffodils. Plus in Kilkenny City, we meet a couple who run a B&B and who have represented Ireland at St. Patrick's Day events on the west coast of America as honoured guests of the city of San Diego.
This evening on Nationwide, we'd like to celebrate St. Patrick's Day by giving you an extra bit of excitement at home. We're giving you the opportunity to win €5,000 cash. So have pen and paper at the ready. We'll give you the details later in the programme. But first, an extraordinary story of a couple in Kilkenny who have represented Ireland at St. Patrick's Day events in America. Now, people in the hospitality industry meet famous and not so famous people all the time. But one guest that came from America to Kilkenny never forgot the proprietors of a local B&B. Helen McInerney went to meet them.
Angela and John Byrne run a very successful bed and breakfast business in the heart of Kilkenny City. Their B&B is very popular with visitors from home and abroad. Of course, their business has been disrupted this year because of the COVID-19. And the couple, like everyone else in the hospitality trade, are hoping that things can return to normal soon. But over the past 30 years, they've hosted visitors from all over the world. One, however, stands out because he changed their lives. It was 17 years ago when this Californian visitor came to stay at the Kilkenny B&B.
It's unbelievable, really, what happened. It was in 2004, this gentleman, very tall, and his daughter came to stay for a few days. We hit it off like a house on fire.
Jim Whelan was born in New York City and knew little of his Irish ancestry. He had been a military man and had served his country in the Korean War. He eventually settled in California, where he married and raised a family. In the summer of 2004, he came to Ireland with his daughter Kathleen to search for his Irish ancestry. Angela began the search and discovered that Jim's ancestors came from Ross Gray in County Tipperary and from Cork.
So lo and behold, anyway, I got on the computer. After about 5 minutes, I had his house and photographed everything. So he was forever grateful for finding his ancestral home. All the leaves are brown.
When Jim returned to America after his holiday in Ireland, he kept in contact with Angela and John. And some months later, he asked the couple to come to California to take on a role that they had never dreamed of for themselves. It transpired their American friend was to the fore of Irish American life in California.
He rang me one day and he said, would you and John represent Ireland at the St. Patrick's Day parade here? It's the biggest parade west of the Mississippi. And I said, well, I don't really know. Can we do that?
Angela had no idea she could represent her country at such an event. But being a good citizen, she thought there was only one way to find out.
So I said, I'm going to write to Taoiseach, which was Bertie Ahern at the time. I'll ask him, can we do that and how do we go about it? So Bertie wrote back straight away and he said he was very proud of me and John for doing this, and he gave us his blessing and told us to send his greetings to all the people in San Diego because he was there before and he knew lots of people in the commerce side of San Diego.
Once she had received the blessing of the Taoiseach, the Kilkenny couple headed to California for what would be the trip of a lifetime. When they arrived in San Diego, they were treated like celebrities. They were accommodated in a beautiful hotel and appeared on American television. And they got to take part in the St. Patrick's Day Parade as honoured guests.
Oh Lord, I can't tell you how much excitement and how much we had to sort out before we went. We had, is our passports in date? Is our this? Is our that?
And what about your outfits?
Oh my God, I went to the top designer in Kilkenny at the time, and she kitted me out in a fabulous chiffon green with tones of cobalt blue going through it and tones of yellow, but really Irish. She made a jacket and a skirt that had layers and layers and layers. I felt like queen of the world.
Welcome to San Diego's most popular local morning news. Good morning, San Diego.
You're in from Kilkenny, right?
We're from Kilkenny and it's Southeast Ireland, and we own the Celtic House Bed and Breakfast. So all you Americans out there, please come to Ireland, to Kilkenny, because we would love to have you.
That first trip was a great success. In a TV interview, they brought greetings from Kilkenny and from Ireland, and in one appearance, they were even asked to sing.
This man that was interviewing me, he said to me, do you think you might sing an Irish song? We had somebody earmarked to do it, but our sound system didn't work. So what can you give us a rendition of some kind of a thing? So I broke out into Hail Glorious St. Patrick.
Hail Glorious St. Patrick, dear saint of our isle, on us thy poor children bestow a sweet smile. For now thou art high in the heavens above, on San Diego this morning look down with thy love.
It went, there was millions of people messaging into the station, telling us they'd love to hear that song again. Oh my God, I thought I was a film star now or some kind of a singer, which I'm not, but they loved it.
What a fantastic rendition. You've got a wonderful wife here, and are you having fun in San Diego?
Certainly, really enjoying ourselves here. It's a lovely place, and we're honored to be here.
Hail, glorious St. Patrick, dear saint of our eyes.
Since that first experience in 2004, Angela and John have gone back to San Diego every year around St. Patrick's Day, and their celebrity status has grown and grown.
Everybody wants a bit of us, everyone wants to hear us talking, but we've made great friends there as well, and we're instrumental in bringing lots of people to Ireland from San Diego. But I have now branched out into a lot of TV there. I also have branched out into talks at the Rotary Club. I go to book clubs. I'm like the celebrity. Well, I feel like one. When I'm there, I feel like it.
Life has many twists and turns. An Irish-American in search of his roots came to stay at a B&B in Kilkenny, and the proprietors, John and Angela, began a journey that brought them to America and introduced them to so many people and places. Sadly, the man that brought them on this great adventure died in 2017 at the age of 85. Angela and John were heartbroken, but they'll never forget their American friend and are determined to keep up their connections in San Diego. This year, just as the Taoiseach has had to cancel his visit to Washington, Angela and John will not be travelling to the USA, but they look forward to returning once the restrictions are lifted. Here in Ireland, with the visitor numbers on the floor over the past year due to the pandemic, the B&B has been very quiet.
This year is unbelievable because of the COVID and all the businesses have gone finished, and we're always so busy and everything and meeting people and everything from all over the world. And we still don't know how we're fixed as regards the COVID. And it's a worrying time because, if you're over a certain age, they say 70 and that, but I don't think 70 matters. I think everyone has to be really careful and mind themselves.
It's a stressful time for Angela and John, but one of their favourite ways to relax is to escape to their attic studio and lose themselves in their art.
You're focused on the picture. you're focused on everything that's in there, the colours, the shapes, the movement, and you can't think about anything else. So if I spend an hour or two painting, I'm in a different world.
Visits to America opened new chapters for Angela and John. One result has been the writing of chapters of her own. Not only one book has been written, but three, and now Angela has embarked on a fourth.
At 60 years of age, I began to write. Write about things I knew, write about things in the family, things that happened, and about 20,000 words in, I'm thinking, do you know something? I think this could be a book. And every day I wrote 1,000 words. The book was launched here in Kilkenny. It had a huge market in America, and it was shortlisted for an American Writers Award. That kind of blew me away, really, because, oh my God, now I can do this. So I set out then to do the three and finish the three, and they became bestsellers on Amazon.com just before Christmas, where, you know, everybody was buying books and all that kind of thing. But nobody really knows, you know, what can happen. You have to get yourself out there.
The couple say they've been blessed in life. They've taken all the opportunities that life has sent them. And now, even in these COVID days, they maintain a positive outlook. They take great joy in their family, who live close by.
Give hope out there to everybody who's, you know, would love to write or would love to sing or would love to do act, or, you know, go for it, because life is short. You really need to do what you want to do. Don't have any regrets when you get old. Do everything.
The couple have done their country some service at home and abroad, and they remain proud representatives of Ireland and County Kilkenny wherever they go.
Angela and John are really looking forward to opening up again after COVID, and they're hoping to travel to the USA next year. Now it's competition time, and we'd like to brighten up somebody's St. Patrick's Day by giving one very lucky viewer a whopping €5,000 cash. You could fill your wardrobe with your favourite Irish brands, you could book your favourite luxury hotel when it is safe to do so, or you could save for a rainy day. It's up to you. So for your chance to win €5,000, answer this. What symbol is associated with St. Patrick's Day? Is it a shamrock, sheep, or a sword? If you know the answer, call 1517 717 15. That's 1517 717 15. Or text the word nation followed by answer and name to 57001. Calls from the Air Network will cost €2.03. Calls from other networks may be higher. You must be over 18 to enter the competition. Lines will close at midday on Tuesday, the 16th of March. Further details are on www.rte.ie/competitions, where the lucky winner will also be revealed. The very best of luck to you. Now, after the break, we visit a farm where the crop is flowers. Stay with us.